Hello there, and welcome to This is the Police, Day 12. So, we've got the Orthodox priest bribes a mayor. We've got the Greek priest to become appointed to the head of Friedberg Orthodox Church. Don't know how that happened. And student volunteers to help the farmers. Alright, so straight into the game, let's go. Ooh, cutscene.
My morning ritual was plagued by the smell of Vickers Varga's fruity cologne.
Yeah, it did smell
like
it, didn't
it? Sharp citrus
Ugh.
Scent was chasing me around the house, as if Vickers was right there in my living room.
Ew.
When I finally realized the smell was coming from a big basket of oranges, it didn't put me any more at ease. I'd opened my door to lots of threatening mail, evidence of criminal
that
wrongdoing,
kind of don't eat
even
them.
A dead ferret or two.
It's probably a head in
but
there.
Fruit? Never.
Why is the fruit? I mean, about your head inside it or something?
You the fruit guy?
Excuse me?
Was it you that brought the basket of oranges?
Nah, it was here when I arrived.
So who are you?
Fine. So who are you?
Today, I'm your driver.
And where are we driving?
To work.
That's it?
Yeah, we have to make an important stop along the way.
There's always
where?
A stop
ranch.
On the way.
What ranch?
Just the ranch.
No, crap.
Fine.
Is that the kind of ranch where we sort of get rid of... Yeah, it is. It's one on the map I can send people when I don't want them
the
to find out about me.
The morning seemed surreal, and I took in the magic. Why wreck it with meaningless chatter? As my tight-lipped chauffeur drove an hour through God knows where, I started to feel like I was in the middle of a bad dream, probably lying bloody and concussed in the alley behind the old Colony Club, my nose buried in a rotten orange.
It was the orange guy. The guy with the oranges.
No,
he did it.
This was no dream. The silence was real. The sound of the engine was real.
How'd
the
you
dust
know?
Was real enough,
dreams
too.
Can be real, too.
And there was the ranch over the horizon. It all seemed familiar. The Sand family's overbearing mansion has been the talk of the headlines for decades. But few have managed to get closer than a few miles. I guess I'm just lucky.
And if you get away, we'll call you lucky, all right? Yeah. Well, there's a boat on the wall. That's always a good sign. What's that? Planks? Ugh, maybe not. Hello, Mr. Black. Nice red chair you have there. Oh, I've seen you before. You're the phone man.
I didn't know you took private meetings, Mr. Sand.
Only if I expect good company.
Then, surprised my company ranks at all.
Today, yes. Today is a special day.
Oh, crap.
So it seems.
Do you often go to the old Colony Club, Jack?
No.
Every
Never.
Week.
Never seen it. Don't
Meet
know where it is.
Interesting people there?
As a rule, no.
Sometimes you make a date, right? Sometimes make new friends.
No. Nope.
Sometimes, I guess. But
I usually
go
for a
drink.
And why?
I consider it a hobby.
A hobby. Do you know anything about my hobbies?
Killing people?
Well, judging
answering?
By the half dozen animal skins I stepped on walking over here, it's not much of a reach to say you like hunting.
Love it. Well, I say that now. It seemed so tedious when I was a child. Took ever so long. But now I'm older. I've developed a new talent.
Interesting
well,
killing?
What talent is that?
Patience. The will to wait for the right moment. Let's say you want a deer. You know, you deserve it. You've even decided what dishes its meat will go to and where you'll mount its horns. But to get that deer, you've got to wait. To sit in the bushes and stay nice and quiet. Professional hunters will tell you that the hunt is a rare craft. There are many rules. It's shrouded in mystery and ancient skill. Well, that's all complete nonsense. To get a deer, you just sit on the sidelines for a long enough time, pinpoint the moment when it's finally time to shoot. I learned the talent, Jack, but not like you, oh, Jack. You truly are the master.
I don't understand.
Oh, come on, Jack. I know about the half million. I know your plan. Kendrick told me everything. Needless to say, I'm impressed.
All right,
well,
what's your deal?
Learn to hold their
what's your offer?
It's on end and not to rustle the leaves too loudly. Why, you decided to just become the foliage. You turned yourself into a bush, surrounded by deer who've been so fruitfully multiplying for decades. But all this time, you've held your rifle at the ready.
Give me my half mil.
His imagery, Jack. I've the heart of a poet, I confess.
That wasn't poetry.
Like, I don't know what was said between you and Kendrick, but it sounds like you got it wrong.
What do you need for my half mil?
I understand everything just fine. And I think we understand each other quite well. Jack, in the coming war, we'll make excellent partners.
What war?
One war falls upon every generation. My grandfather drove out the Ambersons back when he was 27. My father destroyed that psychopath gangster, Boris Bell, when he was a sprightly 30.
Okay.
At 69, I'd begun to think my war had passed me over. But my time
is that other guy, isn't
passed.
It? It's that guy at Metz.
Tomorrow, Vicus Varga declares war.
There we go.
And I'm obliged to answer.
How do you know it's declare war tomorrow?
We're talking about Varga now.
I don't know how he thinks. I don't even know whether he plans his actions or not. I can't divine his purpose. Hell, I don't even know where he comes from.
Snake Alley.
He's a man not of our breed, wouldn't you say? But when he arrived here, I invited him in, told him we could work together. An official invitation penned in my own hand and written on some very expensive paper.
Why?
And can you imagine his reply? A fruit basket. What sense can be made of such a message?
I guess it means whatever you want it to.
It means no.
Precisely.
I'm late for work, Mr. Sand.
What do you want?
Jack, I could just give you $500,000 right now.
Deal.
Cash,
and I walk away. Good.
You like. But I would never insult you so. If I went stalking my
people, never want
so
to give
years,
me the money, do they?
I want someone else to shoot it for me. I understand you, Jack. And I'll never ask you for anything that's contrary to your nature. Just think about our conversation.
Give me the half mil.
Think
no killing, no murdering, no death. And then we deal. No? No, right then. Don't people just give you the money, do they?
Like I said, it's a whole new life. And I've had to give up some old habits. One of them, keeping away from things that don't concern me.
Everything concerns you
now.
Now
I can't afford the luxury. This spotlight I'm under, concerns is all
I got.
Gotta
keep the mayor on the good side at the same time, so that's gonna be an awkward one. Alright, so we have to choose to help Varga, or help Sand. Now the thing is, I think we help Sand. We're already got a relationship with Sand. If we choose Varga, then we end up in a war with Zaga. That looking like I'm born them, and I think we kind of like the idea we stick with Sand. Better the devil you know. So, bum ba dum ba dum ba dum ba dum ba dum. Sand me! The war begins today. On the slowest telephone ever.
Tell him it's Boyd.
Alright, so. Shift B goes into today. They actually got a pretty decent shift as well. And nobody wants a day off. Well, that's pretty good for us. Straight in we go then. I think today we'll have... Have we had that blue one yet? I don't recognise it. Blue one it is! Sing 'em. Alright. Welcome to the morning. Ooh, we got gang members. Kyung-Yin Lin turned in to be a member of a gang known as the Red Masks. He could help you take down the gang if you make him an informant. Abso-bloody-lutely. Informants are useful. I want the gang gone. So, if you're at the top, it would just set you down. Everything below. Reward, 20,000. Ooh, that'd be good. Now, do I have to find these people or... Start to investigate. Arrest, bonus 2,000. Can't investigate you, so we'll start our investigation then, Ninghi. Alright, so I need to give you a detective. My detectives are all in use, aren't they? Ooh, yeah. I'm going to pull one of them off on investigation, so I'll be back in a moment. Investigations. Homicide arson. Homicide arson. We have 6 frames over here. Can I have a look at the details of this one? That missing frame. It's... Damn, I really have to figure this one out. Yeah. See, I've tried that. No. I tried that. No. I tried that. No. I tried that. Which means I probably got the wrong way around. Because it could be the car came around the corner, then it was a shot, and then empty. But I can't seem to get the pattern right. It's got to be... Alternative, that's the option. Well, there we go. I was just placing them at random, but hey, I'm always happy to get a little look at things. Trevor Sultan, a known racist. We already know of several previous convictions. Good, we're going to go arrest him. And that means I shall have a detective available. Proceed with your investigation. We will send more detectives when they come available. You. I will send you my best officers. It's almost like I'm not going to send SWAT. I might need SWAT for something big in the future. So, two best officers, and then take care of the hero. Tomorrow's going to be a big day. Don't let anything happen to him. Okay. Here's your week's salary. Excellent. And so, in interviews, we spoke about atrocities committed in the Red Mask Gang. She embellished a lot of dishonest facts. And if you're going to keep people from panicking, you need to take down the gang within the next 4 days. Well, we're on the way to do what we can right now. Ooh, two. Good, I can hire people. Now, we've got Team A is a little bit low by two, actually. So there we go. I want you on Team A. And do we have anybody else? Or these scamp by this round level? So we'll go for the next available person on Shift A. Shift A. There we go. That's our full stop. We're going to try and get more people in if we can. So can I make a request of Town Hall yet? 3 days. Dun 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 dun. Where's the backlog there anyway? What does that do? Oh, it's just our history, basically. That's fine. We are taking care of the hero. We're going to keep this guy safe. He's not working today, so we're good. Hey, well, that's a long one. And a full minute to make a decision. The investigation has started. Ooh. All right, so we'll come back to this one when we have some stills. I'll read these at that point then. It makes more sense to we have something to do with it. But we have a nightclub to investigate here. A massive fight. We received a call from a club manager who said that a brawl broke out in the main hall involving over 20 men. Security are keeping back because some of the contestants are carrying knives. Several wounded are already laying on the dance floor, but who knows? Okay, this one definitely needs SWAT and a paddy wagon, because paddy wagon is what you would use to arrest people. And I'm going to send in three of my best available officers. There we go. There we go. Homicide report. Offender was caught. We're not talking about the officers. Oh, Leo, there you are. You're fine, you're fine. You were able to arrest all the suspects. Excellent. Alright, so we have those guys. Oh, three officers plus SWAT plus paddy wagon is good enough, but I don't think I can get my SWAT back yet, can I? I've been told I can get extra days, like suit services out of them. Hopefully they will. I don't think I have that upgrade yet. Alright, what do we have over here? We have an assault. Two teens walking their dog got in an argument. Eventually, one of them unleashed the dog on the other. The police were caught by a girl nearby who was riding a bike. Okay, I'm going to wait a second. Wait a second. Bring these guys back home. And then I send one of them and one of my rookies. Ooh! It's bigger than we thought it was, sir. What do we do? Send in my two smaller rookies. So I'm going to send those two off to deal with the other thing. Send! Give him a bit of time to get there, because I need to just hold off as long as I can on this one. 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, whoop, 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 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, click. And then you two go out. This is a big ring, so both of you, my most experienced officers, do the job well. And hopefully those guys get back before we need 24 seconds. That's kind of what I was sort of hoping that would come up afterwards. Massive fight, okay. Offender was caught. Officers were unarmed. Civilians are unarmed. Excellent. Everyone gets promotion. Get your asses back to base. I have a job coming up that I really need to get people to. Come on. 16 seconds. Can you get back in time? I don't think we'll get that one, actually. I don't think we'll actually have officers available in time. 10 seconds. Bum, 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 bum. 5, 4, 3, 2... Oh, that's going to be crap, but I don't think we're going to have tech people anyway. A boy is struggling on the ground, barely holding off the angry dog that's trying to grab him by the throat. We can pull on the dog's collar, hit the dog with a taser, 5 shots in the air. Pull on the collar. The dog lets the boy escape, and its owner starts to flee. Borrow the girl's bicycle, run after him, order the teenagers to halt. Run after him. Offender was caught. Officer unarmed. Excellent. My officers are just so close. Again, so close. Homicide. Parishioner Maria Suppertain reported the sounds of gunshots inside the church. A bearded man in a hat entered the confessional, and then a minute later, I heard a few gunshots. Then a man came left the booth, took off his hat, and crossed himself down the pew. But I think he's praying. Officers! I'm going to send three officers of my good officers in. We were literally milliseconds. I could have sent the paddy wagon, maybe? Attempted murder? I kind of want one of those better police officers. I'm going to send one of the better ones in, because I would really do with some more experience on this attempted murder. And we should have plenty of time to do the attempted murder one, shouldn't we? Plenty of time. Bum, 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 bum. See? Plenty of time. Alright, so I'm going to send in major person and second to minor person. Two should be enough. It's attempted murder. Linda Howard, her words slurred, said the dentist paralysed her face during the last visit. The monster sucked me from some kind of poison. Arrest him. Go! So those two should be able to do that job by themselves, hopefully. And we have the homicide report just in. Offender was caught. Civilians were unarmed. And, hey, look, unarmed. Ooh, loot was found. Non-automatic weapons. Ooh, loot. I like loot. You know, we are trying to make some money. Ask the mafia to sell it. You know, guns are worth a little bit. You know, a little bit here, a little bit there. Dun 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 dun. And come on, the curtains are closed. Can we have our loot, money, loot, money, loot, money? Attempted murder. A false alarm. The girl was injected with normal painkillers and overreacted. Fair enough. 24 seconds. We have a terrorism. Ooh, terrorism. I'm going to hold off for you to come back because I'd really like to get my best officer on the terrorism case if we can. If we can. We have a paddy wagon as well. We don't have SWAT, but we have paddy wagon. Okay. And officers are back. Okay. Terrorism. Christopher G's Ice Sandarina. Ooh, okay. So he's going to put me there anyway. An ice cream vendor noticed a suspicious bag which has been lying unsupervised on a bench for the past few hours. You know, the war has been declared, remember? So I am sending in Officer 1, Officer 2, Officer 3, and Officer 4, leaving three officers of medium level for me. Boom. Go. Defend the Strand. Which is also a road in London, apparently. I believe. Maybe not. Maybe it is. I can't remember. All right. Arson report. No new thing. Open the investigation. There's no way these are the right things. So I need one more. I need one more person on the arson. No, we've got two people on the arson already. Receiving stolen property. Can I put more detectives on this? I think I have a spare. I do have a spare. Mole. Moise, get on. Sorry, I thought it was the same thing then. Oh, did they copy the files? No, they didn't. It was just me being a complete idiot. On here, I would like to put on my big person. What does that house mean? I don't know. Mole, work with them. See if we can help them out. They need more resources. There we go. Alright. And stolen goods. Yes, more information. Okay, here we go. Bum 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 ba dum bum ba dum bum. Right hand man. Ning He is a faithful assistant of Ying Jinyan, a founding member of the gang. He's entrusted with the most serious jobs. Ning He keeps his most valuable prizes at home while he arranges their sale. He then brings them to the Wise Dragon's restaurant the day before he's planned to make the deal. The gang must have had an immediate buyer for the necklace, so Ning He brought it to the restaurant the same night he stole it. Usually the restaurant is open around the clock, but it's closed the night before because of an important deal was going down. Ning He has a key to the restaurant. Valuables are kept in the safe under the bar. Okay, so let's see. He returned back to the thing and then he put the stuff in and then he's leaving. So what happens? He has a key, so why would you break open? It was empty the night before. Then he broke in on that one? No, probably the way around, maybe. Actually, that one's going to be relevant. That is actually wrong. That, the bar was empty. It says there, usually around the clock, but was closed the night before. Closed. It says he has a key, so he won't need to break in. So those two are red herrings. I'm going to put those down there out of the way. But we can definitely see how it's going to work now. Because we need something about him sort of getting into a key, that kind of stuff. Alright. We'll continue on that one later. Bum bum bum. 1 AM. Night shift. Ba 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 ba. Wonder if we actually took the other guy on. We'll get one of these other buildings. Terrorism. Officer arrived on the scene and observed there's something moving inside the bag. Okay. Something moving inside the bag. Open the bag? It's moving, so I don't think it's going to be a bomb. Offender was caught. Officer unarmed. Civilians were unarmed. There we go. Don't know what it was, but interesting. Probably did actually say that at some point, didn't it? I didn't read it, damn it. But yes, I think that was clearly one of those things where it was like, yeah, it was moving. If it wasn't moving, it would have been Bomb Squad, but it was moving, so I think we're safe to go. Alright, so we have Team B. Team A, yes, they've already arrived on shift, that's good. Alright. Why do we, I just want to know, why do these guys all have little houses next to their names? Alright, and on shift B, they don't have the house on their name. Is that because they're at home right now? Ah, that could be because they're at home. Possible. Anyway, I don't need any of you going in tomorrow because we have a full shift A in, so I'm glad for you all to rest up for the day. Go home. Damn you, people, leave. Downtown, we've been running around going downtown. Downtown, downtown.